So one of the things that we're working on with Father John's Attic is we're really trying to help families in need, and our motto is really from one family to another. And I was fortunate enough to meet Michael Coleman here early on. I think he was a gift from God. God selected him, as we were laughing about coming over here today, that he and I were to meet, because Michael has really been a tremendous inspiration, help for me. He's someone that he'll tell you in his own words, you know, the road that he's come, and how the two of us together have really started to make some inroads in terms of helping those less fortunate. Michael, what, you know, tell us just a little bit about, you know, your story and how you've come to get to where you are in a beautiful apartment overlooking the cathedral and St. Albans School up on Wisconsin Avenue.
Well, briefly, I could never have the furniture that I've got if it wasn't been for Mark and Father John's church. And, you know, I met Mark. I didn't know how I was going to move to where I was going to move, not alone. Furnished the place, and through Mark and Father John's charity, everything has been going in place. It's been blessed. I'm really blessed by God to know a person like Mark, and I'm all in for Father John's charity. One person helping another. That's our motto, and that's my motto, and that's what I'm going to do. And I just pray that we are successful and that we get what we need so we can give the people what they need. That's what's important.
My phone call kind of came out of the blue to you, and I had my godfather pass away down in Georgia, and I was literally down there and got an email from Father John saying that there was a gentleman, Michael, who needed some help and needed some furniture. And so I was literally going to my godfather's funeral, and his name was Michael as well. So it's real interesting, you know. The story is going to be about the two men named Michael who never met, and a lot of the things that Michael has in his apartment are from Michael Dolan, my great godfather down in Atlanta, who really was the inspiration in getting me back to God. And I remember calling Michael on the road up. I think I called him from somewhere in South Carolina.
Yeah,
that was in South Carolina.
And
Michael just goes, I can't believe it. He said, I was praying on this last night, but you tell him the story.
Yeah, well, Mark called me, and we somehow got together, and I was really in a burden because I didn't have the money to pay people with the little furniture that I had. It was going to cost me over $300 just to get it up to the apartment, much less upstairs. So Mark came there, and since then, one thing happened after the other, and now
Pearlene.
I'm helping Pearlene, a woman I met in Southeast at the soup kitchen, to get her into her apartment. And Mark, they're working with her, and then we got another client, Brandon. But our concept is I help you, you help somebody, they help somebody, and we just keep it going. And somehow Mark has been able to hold it all together. Mark is the glue that holds this all together. But I'm just grateful.
Now that's a scary thing right there.
I'm grateful for God that I met
Mark. That's the guy. That's the glue.
And that I'm able to live on an apartment on Wisconsin Avenue. So things that are happening are beyond my control. They're beyond Mark's control too. I know that. This is God. So thank you. Thank you, Mark.
Good.